I'm now going to introduce my guests on debate number three. We are joined by Piyush Goyal, National Treasurer and Member of Parliament of the BJP. Piyush Goyal, welcome to the debate. Sukendu Shekhar Roy,
hi.
Member of Parliament of the Rajya Sabha of the Trinamool Congress. Ladies and gentlemen, keep in mind the big fight right now is one, of course, in Amethi. Well, the other big fight is Modi versus Mamta. I haven't seen personally in the last one decade two people virtually take each other on in the way in which Modi and Mamta have. And to give perspective on that, the editor Delhi of the Ananda Bazar Patrika, the leading newspaper of Bengal, is Jayanta Ghoshal. Before I begin the debate, this is what has happened. One is playing the Bangladeshi immigrant card, the other wants him arrested for it. Potential allies till a month back, perhaps. But Modi and Mamta are at loggerheads as the war of words gets really nasty between them. Sukendu Shekhar Roy of the Trinamool Congress, before I begin the debate, please tell me, and please tell our viewers, and please, more importantly, tell Piyush Goyal of the BJP tonight. Where did Narendra Modi say that I will remove all Bengali-speaking Muslims? That Mamta has made it an issue like that. Where did he say that? Please point out at his exact words.
If you have gone through the records of all the public meetings that were addressed by Mr. Narendra Modi,
yes,
both in Bengal and in Assam since 8th of February this year, you will find in a number of meetings, particularly in Bengal, in Srirampur meeting, he categorically stated the people who have come from the other parts of Bengal, that is Eastern Bengal, after 1947, they will be pushed back. This is the language that uttered by Mr. Narendra Modi. And unfortunately, this gentleman does not understand the meaning of the word refugee. He cannot distinguish between a refugee and an infiltrator. He should go by the ordinary dictionary meaning of the refugee and the infiltrator. The people who had to leave their residence from East Bengal pursuant to the partition of Bengal in 1947. I can quote only one line from the book. You need not read the history book of Bipan Chandra or R.C. Majumdar or any other historian. Mr. Tathagata Rai, who is a BJP leader and he is contesting from South Kolkata constituency this year, he has written a book which is titled My People Uprooted. In chapter 4 of that book, I am quoting only one line from that book. I quote, he says in that book that the decision to partition the province of Bengal,
okay,
was a personal victory of Shyama Prasad Mukherjee, who had all along been campaigning for such partition, unquote. Who was Shyama Prasad Mukherjee? He was the founder president of Johnson, and BJP is the offspring of that Johnson. And the BJP leader has claimed that their founder president should be credited for the partition of Bengal. And as a resultant effect, 1 crore of people had to leave their ancestral home for no fault of theirs, and for decades together they had to fight for their survival, and they are still fighting.
They say
some of them have died.
They say that
these refugee families, they will have to be pushed back. This is the clarion call given by the BJP self-styled prime ministerial candidate Mr. Narendra Modi in the heart of Bengal.
Mr. Piyush Goyal, why? Why? Why does Narendra Modi give a communal and religious colour to what is an issue of illegal infiltration? I'd like to remind you, your party's position till recently has been that the issue of illegal infiltration, whether in Assam or Bengal, is not a communal one. And yet, this is what Narendra Modi says. He says, those who observe Durga Ashtami and speak Bengali are Mother India's children. Durga Ashtami and speak Bengali are Mother India's children. That is the most blatant religious overtone. Why, Mr. Piyush Goyal, why is he doing this?
Well, Arnab, I think you are very well aware that there was this sinister design of the Congress since Mr. Roy has gone back to the independence movement to let Bengal go whole soul out of the country. and it was the persistent and very serious efforts of certain leaders that protected and saved large parts of Bengal. Even after that, there were a large number of Hindus who were in the other side of Bengal, in the Bangladesh side, who were persecuted over the years. And you are well aware that India has absorbed people of all communities, faiths, but Pakistan and Bangladesh has persecuted the Hindus who chose to remain there. Over the last few years, there's hardly any Hindu left. After all, if those Hindus in these two neighboring states are persecuted and are left with no alternative but to come to India.
So it's a change of position.
Of India to allow
therefore,
them
it is a change of position.
And that is why in our,
it is a change
of
position.
In our manifesto also. Yes.
So why are you changing your position, Mr. Goyal?
In our manifesto, we have said. In our manifesto,
I know what
said
you've said in your manifesto.
The persecuted minorities. Yeah, if you know it, then you must hear it again. That the persecuted minorities will have a place in India, and India will welcome them with open arms.
Mr.
Any of our brethren who are in Bangladesh or Pakistan, who are persecuted by their local governments, will be welcomed here.
But
illegal immigrants
with
who chose to stay there are not allowed to come here.
Why?
We are not going to tolerate illegal immigrants.
It would
even
be,
if Mamata Banerjee wants to welcome
Mr. Piyush Goyal,
or the Congress wants to welcome
Mr. Piyush Goyal, it would be expected of a prime ministerial candidate to go into details. You are fully aware that the Assam Accord was signed in 1985. That clearly defines, for example, who is an illegal immigrant and who is not. Right, a distinction has to be made, a solid distinction between those who came after 1971 and those who came before that. And when you don't make the distinction, and when you say anyone who celebrates Durga Ashtami and speaks Bengali, in other words, all Bengali Hindus are welcome. All Bengali Muslims will be seen through the prism of suspicion. Sukendu Shekhar Rai responding to Piyush Goyal. Mr. Roy, yes, Jayanta Ghoshal after that.
With
Mr.
Your
Roy.
Question, may I give you an answer?
Hello. Please allow me. We have listened to you. The refugee problem is an international phenomenon, and this is why the United Nations in 1951 and 1962, they adopted the refugee resolution and out of the refugee convention, which every member state will have to act upon. Our Supreme Court, in plethora of cases, have ruled that the refugees have the equal right as of Indian citizens to enjoy the right to life under Article 21 of the Constitution to live with human dignity. Therefore, the gentleman who is projecting himself to be the future Prime Minister of India, he must adhere to the ruling of the Supreme Court and respect the refugees and try to ensure that if we come to power,
sir,
we will ensure implementation of the ruling of Supreme Court.
Sir, the Supreme
without
Court.
Going through that, without
no, I remember,
going
no, no,
through
no,
the
sir, 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 partially
even resolution.
Incorrect. Sir, you're partially.
On communal line.
Mr. Roy.
Keeping an eye on the electoral prospect.
Mr. Roy.
If Mr. Modi
and
is
you,
trying to divide the society on communal line, religious communalism and linguistic communalism,
I will
both
let,
are equally condemnable.
I will
and
let.
The election commission should take note of it.
I will
and
let.
Take strong action against the gentleman who is preaching hatred.
And look at the language.
To divide the society vertically,
sir.
And if he wants to take the pound of flesh of the Bengali people, we are ready to give, but without a drop of blood.
Oh, sir, 1 minute.
Take our pound of flesh, but without a drop of blood.
Mr. Roy, are you overreacting to the situation in July 2005? The Supreme Court, while striking down the IMD.
I am not overreacting. Every patriot should react.
Sir, Sir, the Supreme Court, while setting aside the IMDT Act of 1983, had said that the presence of such a large number of illegal migrants from Bangladesh, which runs into millions, is in fact an aggression on the state of Assam and has also contributed significantly in causing internal disturbances. In terms of insurgencies, maybe you've not read the 114-page judgment of the Supreme Court, Mr. Sukendu Shekhar Rai. You should see the 114-page judgment of the Supreme Court.
That can be tackled in accordance with law.
So what is your complaint with Modi?
Will come on the scene.
Piyush Goyal.
And
Piyush Goyal is responding. Piyush Goyal.
I think Mr. Roy has not understood the refugee and the United Nations Convention, unfortunately. He needs to educate himself what a refugee is.
There are two types of people who cross the border.
One is people who are politically persecuted and who are seeking refuge and asylum. Another is those who are trying to cross the border for economic benefit and gain.
Yes.
Now the minority in the neighboring state of Bangladesh is the Hindu. Please allow me to complete. Sukenduji, I heard your rational arguments.
Okay.
Well, Sukenduji, the people from Bangladesh who are minority over there and are politically persecuted are the ones who are welcomed as refugees seeking asylum in India. The people of Bangladesh who have gone of their own volition there, who are the majority community there, they are coming to India for economic reasons, and nowhere in the world, just for economic reasons, do people allow asylum. If that was to be the case, United States and Europe and all those
religious reasons
would be flooded with people from Bangladesh.
And what about
and
religious
Pakistan.
Reasons, Piyush
so
Goyal?
Please understand.
Piyush
right.
Goyal.
So only when people
Mr. Piyush Goyal.
They are persecuted, are they considered for asylum?
You have not got the meaning of that.
No. One second. I'm going to come to Jayanta Ghoshal before I hit the break. Jayanta Ghoshal.
Are not being religiously persecuted in Bangladesh.
Sir, one second. You said, earlier on the News Hour debate, Piyush Goyal said that the BJP manifesto mentions persecuted minorities from countries like Pakistan and Bangladesh who are welcome to India. But Mr. Piyush Goyal, that is not what your manifesto says. Your manifesto does not mention the word minorities at all. Your manifesto mentions the word Hindus.
Who are the minorities in Bangladesh and
You
Pakistan?
Mentioned the word Hindus.
Because they are the minorities in Bangladesh and Pakistan.
It doesn't say
so
Christians.
Big deal, Arnab, they are the minorities.
Sir.
They are the minorities in Bangladesh
sir,
and Pakistan.
Sir, have there not been atrocities on Sikhs in Pakistan? On Christians in other part of the subcontinent or on Buddhists?
For your information, India welcomes the Sikhs, the Buddhists, the Christians, everybody.
But your manifesto only says Hindus.
Being religiously persecuted.
Your manifesto says Hindus. And you now say those who celebrate Durga Ashtami
are
welcome.
They are the majority of the minorities over there. They are the majority of the minorities, therefore they have been mentioned.
Jayanta
Ghoshal.
But
you are well aware that India has a convention and we have always allowed any religiously persecuted minorities, including the Jews, including the Parsis, safe haven in India.
Okay, one second. Now, this is all happening in a broader context, ladies and gentlemen, because people believe that there could have been a possibility of Mamata providing some kind of outside support to the BJP if required. However, Narendra Modi's overall politics over the last 1 month has been to take on every regional satrap head on, and that seems to be part of a strategy. Sukendu Shekhar Roy smiles. Before I go to the debate, I'd go across to my senior colleague, Jayanta Ghoshal. Mr. Ghoshal, before I go into the break and I continue this debate, tell me who's right and who's wrong. Is Modi wrong in giving a religious twist, or is the Mamata wrong in overreacting to what Modi said? Mr. Ghoshal.
No, Arnab, what Mamata is saying, I think it is correct, because there is a generalization, the problem of generalization is there. You know, in Assam, woman chief minister, the Taimura, she was Muslim chief minister. She was Bangladeshi or she was Indian. Now you have to identify who is Bangladeshi. The root, it was in Bangladesh, but that doesn't mean that he or she, all the persons came to India are infiltrators. Now, you see, the Bobby Hakim, the minister of Mamata Banerjee, is he a Bangladeshi? Or Hannan Molla, Saifuddin Chowdhury, lot of Muslim Bengalis, were in the West Bengal politics, are they Bangladeshis? So the problem is, there is a problem of generalization, Arnab. When Madan Lal Khurana was the chief minister, this problem happened. And as a Bengali, I have seen the problem in Delhi. Once I asked Madan Lal Khurana, who is Bangladeshi? And he told me that usually we are detecting Bangladeshis who speak Bengali. I said that I speak Bengali, and he said that you are not Muslim. then if one Muslim, and if he speaks Bengali, you cannot identify the person as Bangladeshi. And Bal Thackeray also once did the same problem. My good friend Piyush knows it. So now Arun Jaitley and Piyush, what they are trying to correct the position.
No, I don't think they're connecting.
The illegal immigrants. I know that.
Arnab, I don't know why he's referring to people.
Arnab, I know.
He's quoting some fanciful things for people.
Give me the opportunity to complete my sentences. No. Just one sentence.
Yeah, but
that I don't know that I cannot go to America without a proper visa.
Which are completely lopsided and false.
So the Bangladesh. No. But this the problem of generalization is there. I mean, you cannot generalize all the Muslims who speak Bengali are not Bangladeshis. That is the only thing I want to say.
But we have never generalized. You are generalizing, sir.
No, but then why do you bring a Durga Ashtami reference? You can say Bangladeshi. Why do you bring a Durga Ashtami reference?
You're asking me?
Yes, Piyush. Why do you bring a Durga Ashtami reference?
Well, by the way, for your information, Arnab, Durga Ashtami is very proudly and happily celebrated by all persons in West Bengal. For all the people of West Bengal, Durga Ashtami is almost like a symbol of their own being there.
Sir,
it's not about only Hindus or the Muslims.
It's
a very Bengali tradition.
No, I'll tell you, sir, among the traditions I'd like to mention
is that
we remember why this is
everybody
a touchy issue.
Everybody participates in Ganesh Utsav.
No, why this is a touchy issue, Mr. Goyal, and if you look at the entirety of it, India's first freedom fighter who took on the British single-handedly, Nawab Sirajuddaula, who died in the Battle of Plassey. Right, this is the tradition there. Now Nawab Sirajuddaula, who died in the Battle of Plassey, fighting the British, in today's narrow context, will you say, where did he belong? There is therefore
and
lots of...
Sirajuddaula was Arabian by blood.
Exactly. So there are...
Sirajuddaula was Arabian by blood.
The point I'm making, Mr. Piyush Goyal... Mr. Piyush Goyal, the point I'm making is that Bengal's culture is very composite even from a religious point of view. That's the point.
But all those who are Bengalis, we welcome them. We believe that all of them have the right to the resources of Bengal, and which is exactly what the Supreme Court said. And you just mentioned half the Supreme Court order. The other half said the aggression represented by large-scale illegal migrants from Bangladesh had made the life of the people wholly insecure.
So, but how do you know?
And the panic generated thereby had created fear psychosis.
So read the whole
Supreme Court order.
Now watch. Just one quick point here. Today, I'm coming to Sukendu Shekhar Rai. The other point is the nature of Mamata Banerjee's response and whether she has overreacted. I'm going to mention this and then go into a break because I have to and then come out. What does Mamata Banerjee say? Did you hear what your leader said? She says, I'm just trying to pull out the exact quote. She says, Narendra Modi should be arrested first. A rope should be tied around his waist and he should be taken to the jail. Was that an overreaction? I'm going to get your response on the other side of the break on News Hour Debate number 3. Coming back. Sukendu Shekhar, I justify that comment. Tie Narendra Modi up in a rope and pull him back.
Yes.
Pull him to jail. I mean, she can also respond to Modi,
about,
but this
what
kind
about,
of...
What about, you may not agree with the language or the tone, but whatever my leader, Ms. Mamata Banerjee, has said, she has meant to say that stern action should be taken by the Election Commission of India because Mr. Modi has not only violated the Model Code of Conduct, but he is spreading venom on the communal line. He is trying to divide people and create a fear.
She wants to be seen to be the person taking
the
on Narendra Modi because it suits her purpose.
Okay. And the religious minority.
Okay, Piyush Goyal.
Arnab, you are right when you say You are right when you say that Bengal is having a composite culture, and for that matter, India is also having a composite culture. Swami Vivekananda in his Chicago address said that I represent a country where many caravans came from different parts of the globe. This is our cultural heritage. And looking at the elections and after assessing this ground reality that the Gujarat model is no longer accepted by the people,
respond.
He is trying to create fear psychosis in the minds of the linguistic minority and religious minority in the manner which is not only be condemnable,
no, you know,
but
Piyush Goyal,
every patriotic citizen must take note of it and reject this type of cruel politics.
Piyush Goyal responding now, limited time on this debate. Yes, Piyush Goyal.
Arnab, you know, once the opinion polls and the data started coming in, I think Ms. Mamata Banerjee and the entire party got so badly unnerved. They could see the BJP surging ahead, and they could see that the vote percentage had almost gone beyond 20%. And the reaction of Ms. Banerjee and her party clearly reflect that they are an unnerved lot. We have seen them behave with the Election Commission with utter disdain. My honorable leaders, Mr. Arun Jaitley and Ramakrishna Ji, went and met the Election Commission today. We are very concerned that the West Bengal government, in utter disregard of Election Commission norms and disregarding the presence of paramilitary forces, they have neutralized them by giving them some routine duties and are pressurizing the West Bengal police for booth rigging and malpractices. We have complained against it. We have sought the Election Commission to take action against this inept government, and therefore they are so unnerved.
This government,
they are trying to divert the issues. I think the debate today is about development, it's about progress.
But Mr. Goyal,
we have seen the kind of development West Bengal
Mr.
has
Goyal,
even in the last
Mr. Five Goyal, admit it. Mr. Goyal, it's a long election. Mr. Goyal, admit it, it's a long election. And everyone's, you know, I'm sure there's an element of fatigue which picks up. But Mr. Goyal,
no fatigue, we are fresh as hell.
But Mr. Goyal, you know, you are saying opinion poll surge, etc. Anyway, I won't tell you what you say about opinion polls in other contexts. That's not the issue. The issue is this, and I want to get Jayanta Ghoshal on this.
I never criticize opinion polls. Arnab,
except when they don't work for you.
That we can learn a lot from opinion polls.
No. So my question is not that. My question is not that, Mr. Goyal. Mr. Goyal, my question is not that. I remember. No, I remember.
But not when you do party polls with 1,000 respondents.
I remember.
1,000 respondents with
1,000. Well, I think.
Despite India shining or not.
Anyway, of late the BJP quotes the opinion polls quite a lot. That's not the point. The point is, last question to Jayanta Ghoshal.
We quote credible opinion polls, not some of which some of your panels do or your channel and newspapers do, which are based on 1,000 respondents.
Mr. Piyush Goyal, I am pretty sure. I am pretty sure. Now, anyway, let me go to the point. I am pretty sure that you have a lot of people doing opinion polls for you. And I can equally turn back and say to you, Mr. Piyush Goyal, that I don't believe your opinion polls either.
Mr. Piyush Goyal, I have internationally reputed companies.
Yes, I'm sure.
Polls, and my size is over 100,000 every time.
So you can.
Poll,
so if you think.
So
equally, Mr. Piyush Goyal, I don't want to beg, you know, push the point. But anybody will ask you. In a country of 1.2 billion people, throwing back your own argument at you, how do you believe that 100,000 people in a sample survey, because you have a lot of money and you have money to spend, represents the nation? Anyway, that's not the question. The question is here tonight to Jayanta Ghoshal.
It's about the money. It's about the effectiveness of...
Mr. Goyal, no, one question. Jayanta Ghoshal. We will debate that another day.
They are internationally...
We'll debate that another day, Mr. Goyal. My last question tonight. Why has this happened, Jayanta Ghoshal? I remember Narendra Modi when he went to the brigade ground and made that speech. He said there's Narendra Modi in the center, there is Mamata Banerjee in the state, and there is also Pranab Mukherjee and Rashtrapati Bhavan. He was hinting at something else. It was nice, cozy arrangement. What happened, Jayanta Ghoshal? It was such a cozy arrangement.
Now, is No, you see, in political assessment of Narendra Modi and the BJP leadership, they have understood that they have realized that there is a wave of Modi in Bengal. That is their understanding, and they are thinking that they should not be shown as a just ally of Mamata, or only NDAism cannot give the proper result. Because in 2004 and 2009, BJP lost actually lot of seats only for this coalition dharma.
Yeah.
So now this time the strategy is not only against CPM, the ruling party is Trinamool, and after 3 years there is an anti-incumbency, that's a law of nature. So we should explore the discontent of the Bengali people, and that is the strategy. So there is a change of strategy in BJP also under the leadership of Narendra Modi. But you know, yesterday also, but Arnab, one thing you
very interesting.
Yesterday also Narendra Modi clarified about the laddu and rasagolla.
Need to close.
And
Piyush Goyal was,
he actually meant when he said that in Delhi I will be there, and in Delhi and in West Bengal Mamata will be there, and he disassociated the Bengal development issue.
Point is
from,
taken. Point is taken. So they are taking a calculated call. Yes, Piyush, very briefly. I'm short of time. Piyush Goyal, very briefly.
Well, very briefly.
He has taken a calculated risk.
The fact is that the BJP is surging ahead nationally. Every region of India, north, south,
we'll
east,
see.
West, Modi is there. Everybody is looking at him with hope and
Shukendu Shekhar Rai, I'm short of time.
It's very clear that we are moving towards the national majority.
One line. One line to Shukendu Shekhar Rai.
One line.
It seems that there is a grand alliance between the BJP, CPIM and Congress, because the way the Congress and CPIM are alleging against
BJP and CPM, that's interesting.
Commission today, BJP has followed the suit.
Don't stretch it. If you are suggesting that Sitaram Yechury and Narendra Modi are working together, I know many things can happen, but that level of fantasy has not been reached yet. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining me on debate number 3 on the news hour tonight.